7 days, 7 continents. Quite a way to squash a world record.
This last week has been an exceptional week in my life.
Exceptional is one way to describe what Peter Nichol and Tim Garner finished Saturday at Chelsea Piers in Stamford. The pair of former nationally ranked squash players completed a week-long journey around the world to showcase the game.
Well, the idea is to show that squash is played in every continent, and there's communities in every continent who are passionate and caring about the sport, and it's certainly done that.
Stamford was the last leg of a trip that included stops in London, Kuala Lumpur, and the Falkland Islands. The idea behind it all was to showcase the game's popularity, because ultimately, Nichol and Garner want squash in the 2020 Olympics.
The top players in the world, an Olympic gold will mean everything. I would change my world number one, my British Open, my US Open titles for an Olympic gold.
Squash players are some of the best athletes in the world. To be a high-level squash player, you need to be fast, you need to be agile, you need to have great strength.
Two players on a court, it's gladiatorial, but it's also fair. There's a certain etiquette about the game as well that I think fits the Olympic ideal.
Moving away from just what the athletes bring to the table, squash is truly global.
Over 200 players turned out to celebrate on Saturday. And Nichol says that shows squash has plenty of support behind it.
Squash deserves to be in because it is truly a global sport, but played and enjoyed all around the world.
So many people care about the fact that, you know, squash, we really want it to be an Olympic sport.
We've made those differences that we can then go back to the IRC and say, listen, we've done this, we've made the changes. We are the sport that you want.
The 7 Continent Challenge also raised money for 2 charities. You can learn more about those and read personal blogs from Garner and Nichol online at 7continentchallenge.com.